Today on Typical Books, we're going to be talking about how I am a terrible, no good, very bad BookTuber. How I'm the worst YouTuber, maybe, in the entire planet. I had watched Rachel from the Shades of Orange do bad at BookTube, and I think it's based off of a Daniel Greene video, The Worst YouTuber, which I never watched that whole video. I don't watch that channel a lot, but I do watch Shades of Orange, and she's a bad BookTuber because she never does tag videos, yet she's made a tag without questions. So there's no like real set list of questions to answer for this particular thing. And Olly at CriminOlly did this as well. And I think it's valuable to take a really hard look at what terrible YouTubers we are. And BookTube traditionally is not a niche in YouTube where people follow the YouTube formula. We don't typically use retention editing. We're not about flashy pranks and things like that, you know, and we're not, you know, doing usually like hour-long documentary style videos. We're not doing like the creepypasta thing. And a lot of the algorithm gets confused between a horror BookTube channel and a creepypasta for whatever reason. So we are all the worst BookTubers. A few things that I'll notice off the top is that it's not all negativity. There are tags within BookTube that I've done a few, like behind the BookTube tag, how I BookTube. There's a few other like BookTube newbie and BookTube oldie. Those sorts of tags give you an idea of how we do our channels. This is something completely different, and I think it's really refreshing and needed because I was watching Rachel's video and sort of like laughing and crying and smirking and shaking my fist at clouds in agreement. And also just, you know, there are some very different things with our channels. Olly and Rachel have much larger channels than I do. I don't have a lot of subscribers at all, and I don't get near the amount of views that they do. Yet we've all been here quite a while. We all have hundreds of videos. I have 320 some videos, and they both have a lot of videos. So we have a lot of the same sort of things that we do, don't do, could do better, maybe don't care to do better in YouTube. But yeah, so I did really enjoy it, and I think that you will enjoy this little journey about the very bad, no good BookTuber. And I'm not here to be like super negative, even though there are like negative things that we'll talk about and negative things that come up in the videos. And I think a lot of it boils down to our channels could be more successful, but ... we do these things. Maybe, or maybe these are the reasons why our channels are successful. The first point is that I'm obviously a very bad BookTuber because I've been here 10 years and have less than 5,000 subscribers. So I'm obviously doing something wrong. Like, it's obvious how bad of a BookTuber I am. But, you know, it is a really small niche. Horror BookTube is small. Like, BookTube is small within YouTube. Horror BookTube is even smaller still. And when you look at all of YouTube, there's a lot of channels that come and go really quickly. There's a lot of little channels that stay very little forever. And I sort of give in to the idea that I'll probably remain a very small channel forever. That's another caveat, is that I do YouTube videos on BookTube specifically for fun. I have fun with this, and that's part of the problem in a way you'll see in future points in this video. But yeah, I'm not in it to become a full-time, stick this on easy mode, let's get a million subscribers as fast as possible, go. There are a lot of weird shortcuts that some channels are taking. Now, I can't say that I don't notice these channels that show up, have 5 videos on their channel, have twice as many subscribers as I do, and 100,000 views. You know, I do notice that, and it's weird to me that that can happen when a lot of us on BookTube, horror BookTube specifically, post a lot and work hard and post regularly and have a community, but remain extremely small. When all of a sudden a new channel shows up and they're very, very big, very fast, whatever. There's some sort of magic I don't understand, obviously, because I'm a bad BookTuber. But yeah, obviously I'm very bad because I only have 5,000 subscribers. I don't think I'm a bad YouTuber per se, in that I have a lot of fun doing this. I'm going to start it all out by saying this is a hobby for me. I'm not looking to make this a business. necessarily. I mean, it would be great if I retired. I would make a lot more videos and treat it more like a business, I believe. Although it is treated like a business when it comes to the monetary sense, legally. But I don't, in my heart, treat it as a business. The reason for this might be point number two. I'm a terrible YouTuber because I keep experimenting with everything. Behold, you may notice that I've redone my shelves. This took hours today, hours and hours. And I don't have a consistent backdrop all of the time, you may have noticed. It'll stay the same for some time, but I do like to change it. And I wish I could change it more often, but books are heavy. And I have a different lighting. I have different lighting again today. I've made this video three times, and we'll get to that reason later in the video, but that has to do with me being a terrible BookTuber. I play with the sound, I play with the microphones, I play with the cameras. I've switched cameras and camera styles a couple times just today. But yeah, I like setting up different lights and experimenting with the tone, the look, the pacing, all sorts of things with my videos. And that's part of the fun for me. It's not only enjoying reading horror books that I love or talking about horror books. I like editing, I like making the videos, I like playing with the lighting. I have a lot of light stands and lights from being a photographer, and I like using them on my show. So I experiment way too much. The best channels, it seems to me, the ones that have a great community and lots of views and probably make loads of money, all look the same all the time. Upload consistently at the same time and day every week, which life keeps getting in the way of YouTube and taking precedence. There's nothing I can really do about that. So yeah, I'm not consistent. I keep experimenting, and this makes me a terrible BookTuber. The third point is that I am a wretched BookTuber. I'm wretched, haggard, and I'm not a beardy hipster dude that everyone wants to hang out with. I'm not that cool young 20-year-old girl with really good lipstick and a cool demeanor, or awkward little person that's like a millennial or something appealing. I'm maybe this mix of like Elvira and Martha Stewart. I don't know exactly. Like the modern Shirley Jackson. I don't know really what that means. Therefore, I don't really know what my audience is supposed to be or expect of me, or what sort of audience this draws in. I have no idea. Although I do look at like lots of metrics, and that's another reason we talk about in a bit, but I don't know on a personal level where this all fits. And obviously neither does YouTube, and maybe the world doesn't know because I don't get a lot of subscribers. Tie it all back to point number one. If I were a dude, maybe because there's less dudes on BookTube and less in horror BookTube, they seem to get more views because that's what's something that people want. There's all sorts of things people want from BookTube and don't get, I can't provide. I'm not young. I'm not thin anymore. I'm not old enough to become a wizened guru crone. So, I mean, I don't fit into a popular demographic whatsoever, unfortunately, because I cannot grow a beard and I am not 20. If I were half my age, maybe things would be different. I've gained a whole bunch of weight. Maybe that has something to do with it, but it shouldn't, right? This is the year 2024. Those sorts of things aren't supposed to matter, but I think maybe they do. So I'm wretched, a wretched BookTuber. Point number four, I'm an awful, awful YouTuber because I'm stepping away from social media, mostly, usually. For a long time I have been. I basically use Twitter to check the traffic. I don't have a Discord. I don't like Discord. I've used other people's Discords a little bit, but I hate it. Don't like it. I don't really interact much on Instagram. I have an Instagram and I enjoy it. I have a Patreon, and that's where I like to interact most often, even though I don't seem to be there a heck of a lot. But that is one of the places I have the most bandwidth for because I'm very grateful and thank my patrons for supporting this show and ensuring that I read newer fiction. That's what it's become the point of, to vote on some of the newer books that I'll be purchasing from the new releases lists. It's a great community. And once in a while, I do come there with some behind the scenes information as well. So it's nice, and I really appreciate that. Another social point that I do enjoy is having some fellow BookTubers, horror BookTubers, that I chat with. I talk often with Merce from Harpies in the Trees and Alex at Bookiebus and Regina at Regina's Haunted Library and Marie McWilliams. We talk about BookTube and horror and authors and other stuff in the world and news and things like that. But we do have that social group. So it's part of that, and that's something I'll always have bandwidth for, of course. I do interact here on YouTube. I hear a lot of larger YouTubers and quite a few other BookTubers too, who don't have the time to respond to all the comments they get. And I don't get too many yet. I do get a lot, but I make sure to respond to basically every comment. And it's not that it's hard yet. If I were much bigger, it might be, and I can totally commiserate with not being able to, but that's yet another social media place that I do make bandwidth for. I think that because I don't have a Discord, because I don't spend a lot of time on Instagram or instigate any sort of community there necessarily, I don't spend time on Facebook or Twitter, I would pour all of my energies into the YouTube social media, as it were, which I think makes a lot more sense. So I would have the bandwidth for that. But I don't like social media. I have all the notifications off on my phone because I don't want my pocket buzzing all of the time. And I just don't do social media, which seems to be what most YouTubers do. And it's fostering a community, and I'm not very good at that. I'm just terrible at it. Awful, some might say. But I am, in the fifth point, the worst BookTuber. And this may be controversial in that I like Amazon. I like Amazon. I promote Amazon. I'm an Amazon affiliate, so sometimes links you may see. There's a disclaimer in the comment section below and on my website as well. I use Amazon links. I have an Amazon Prime account, so I watch Amazon things. I order lots of books on Amazon. I'm a writer. I have books that I wrote on Amazon, if you're interested. I have Amazon affiliates, like I said, and I like to look at the list of what people have bought. I should do what Books in the Freezer used to do, which is tell you what other people have bought as a point of interest. But I find it kind of creepy. Not that I make a heck of a lot of money off of that or anything, but it's interesting. It ties into the bookshop link that I also provide because I'm not 100% Amazon-centric. I'm on an Amazon shill. I only buy maybe 30% of the books or 20% that I own from Amazon. But it's necessary because we're in Canada. Sometimes we don't get all the books. We don't have many bookstores. We only have one or two horror bookstores in all of Canada. Some bookstores just don't have a horror section. So it's not easy to get books. It's easier to get them from Amazon. And small bookstores, which I do support, of course, I do most of my shopping at small bookstores. Using Bookshop doesn't work in Canada very well, if at all, because there's just not a lot of small bookstores signed up with Bookshop. It works really good in the US, but I will tell you, not one person has ever clicked on the Bookshop link that I've provided for years. So I like Amazon, and a lot of people don't. A lot of people actively discourage people from using Amazon or refuse to use Amazon. And I don't know if it's all a virtue signaling thing that they provide Bookshop when not many people don't use it. I wish more people did. It's there if you want it. But hey, I like Amazon. Sorry. Point number six is that I am an ineffective YouTuber. Not because I ignore my metrics, but because I do pay attention to them. And this is weird because so many big BookTubers and really popular BookTubers will say, I don't even look at my metrics. I don't understand my metrics. I don't even know where to find them. That sort of stuff. Not that I don't not believe them, but I kind of don't. They're easy to find. And if you're in the partner program, you know where to look for it because you had to go the same place to become a partner. But be that as it may, you could have access to them and know where they are and not look at them. Great. I do. I look at my metrics often. I look at my metrics and I do metrics analysis and I understand what works and what doesn't. I understand what points in my video people click away or what points in my videos people tend to rewatch. I understand what sort of audience I have and demographics when people watch. I understand all of that. Does it help? No, it does not help. I'm an ineffective BookTuber, an ineffective YouTuber, because I look at my metrics, I digest my metrics. It's part of the joy I have of having a channel. I enjoy looking at my metrics, but it doesn't help. It's ineffective. I'm ineffective. Part of the metrics is having the numbers tell you a story and then finding the people that also tell that story. Not to prove the numbers necessarily, but the numbers will point you to where the story is. And I enjoy that. I learned that in journalism. I use it to this day. Numbers aren't just the matrix. Numbers actually describe the people. And I really take that to heart. Is it helpful here on YouTube for me? Not yet. Number 7 is that I am an abhorrent BookTuber. Abhorrent. Because of vanity. Vanity. Yeah, me. Mm-hmm. What do I have to be vain about, you ask? Quite seriously. Not much. But I don't like doing videos without makeup on. I don't. If I don't have makeup on, I don't do a video. If I don't feel like putting on makeup or doing my hair, not that my hair needs a lot of doing, but I recorded this video already because my hair didn't look right. I'm growing out this mohawk and it really makes a big mess of everything. It's hard until my hair is all one length again. It probably won't be easy to do because I've had a mohawk for over a decade and I'm just getting used to this now. But yeah, makeup, another thing. I have deleted videos because my makeup or hair didn't look good. I have stopped editing a video and trashed a video entirely. And not re-recorded it at all because I only had so much time in a day. And yeah, that's happened because I didn't have makeup on. It sounds so petty. And I know that there are many people who can just roll out of bed, it seems, and record a reading vlog or do their videos without makeup on and just throw on a hoodie and a t-shirt or whatever. And that's great. And am I envious? No. From a time management perspective, maybe, but it's just not me. And that's not the comfort level I have. I like to put on makeup. I feel comfortable and prepared when I do that. And it takes time to do that. And not every day has that sort of energy. So yeah, I definitely am an abhorrent, wretched, terrible, abhorrent BookTuber because I need to have makeup on. I have my hair look good. I'm about the same at work though, you know? I do work from home quite often, but I'm not one of those people that work from home in their pajamas. I have work shoes here that I wear in the house most days, especially when I want to feel professional. I don't like roll out of bed and start working. I like take my time and get prepared for my day because that level of preparedness and professionalism is something that I need to feel at my best. Number 8 is maybe the worst. I'm a horrific YouTuber, horrific BookTuber, because all I read is horror. You know, it's not very commercially viable. I should read fantasy, and then I would get a whole bunch of views. I should read series, books in series. People seem to really eat that up. I do a weekly show all the time, catching everyone up on the fantasy series I'm reading. That will do it. Yes, no, I can't, because I like reading horror, and it comes all back to the beginning where I have to do what I enjoy. This is a fun thing for me that I get a lot of joy out of experimenting and playing and making videos and reading horror books. And horror is pretty much all I've ever read. This is a good example of the kind of stuff I like to read. And if you've been on this channel for a long time, you know that I really don't dip out of that. I could read YA, and I do read the occasional YA, but I'm reading less of it actually, because it's just not for me. And if I were a 100% YA horror channel, then there would probably be something to be said for that, you know, but it's just not. And again, I don't know if I present the horror I read in the way that most people would like it to be presented. Not really sure. I don't know. But I am just a most horrific BookTuber because all I read is horror, and I should read more widely to be more acceptable on YouTube. Especially because, and I don't know how this fits in here, YouTube does limit horror. and true crime and all sorts of other topics. It's hard to tell what they limit. If you look at YouTube in restricted mode, which is available in a lot of countries and by some age groups and in libraries and schools, so if you're watching YouTube from library or school or using free Wi-Fi somewhere, they may have it all in restricted mode, and then over half of my channel just disappears. It's not available. So that could be part of it. I don't know. If I read maybe books that didn't have such gory covers and premise, then maybe there would be more watchability. I don't really know. But yeah, horrific BookTuber. Absolutely horrific. The worst, the no good, very most terrible, horrible, bad at YouTube. That's me. So I don't know. If you've done really bad BookTube, are you a terrible YouTuber as well? Are you no good at BookTube? Or do you think that you have ideas on how I could be a better BookTuber? Let me know in the comments below. And thank you twice as much today, ever so much, for watching. And have an ooky, spooky day.